Hillary Clinton came agonizingly close to winning the Democratic presidential nomination in 2008, losing to a freshman senator, Barack Obama. At her concession speech, she cited her lifelong struggle to overcome barriers to women, sometimes referred to as the glass ceiling, and to the 18 million votes she won in primary races.
Although we weren't able to shatter that highest, hardest glass ceiling this time, thanks to you, it's got about 18 million cracks in it. And the light is shining through like never before, filling us all with the hope and the sure knowledge that the path will be a little easier next time.
8 years later, Clinton won the nomination and is hoping to shatter the ultimate glass ceiling and become president. The happy little girl from a middle-class Chicago suburb, daughter of a staunch Republican father, says she got into politics because of her Democratic mother. Dorothy Rodham had a very different childhood.
She was abandoned by her parents at the age of 8, sent from Chicago to L.A. to live with grandparents who didn't want her. But people showed her kindness, gave her a chance. Like the teacher who saw my mother had no money for food and started bringing her extra from home, whispering, "You know, Dorothy, I just brought too much food today."
Hillary started out in her teens as a young Republican. She attended Wellesley College and became more active in politics, delivering the women's school's commencement speech in 1969. She went on to Yale Law School, where she completed her transformation to a progressive Democrat, and met her future husband, Bill Clinton, in the library. She and Bill married in 1975, and she followed him back to his home state of Arkansas, where he was elected governor in 1978. The Clintons' daughter, Chelsea, was born in Arkansas, and it was there that journalist Ron Fournier first covered the Clintons. He had plenty of access to both of them in Little Rock and later at the White House. Fournier told VOA he thinks Hillary is even smarter and funnier than Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton's very good about relating a joke, telling a joke, but she's really good about being funny in the moment. Self-deprecating humor, that laugh that drives a lot of people crazy, I actually find personally very engaging because it's very authentic, it's very earthy, it's very contagious in person.
Former Bill Clinton White House spokesman Bob Weiner told VOA that Hillary Clinton is smarter at understanding a problem and coming up with a solution than Bill Clinton or President Barack Obama, but she lacks something they have.
She knows that she doesn't have the charisma, and she does not have the charisma, but she's got the smarts and the governing power, which is enormous.
Bill Clinton was elected president in 1992, joking that he offered two presidents for the price of one. Bucking traditional expectations, Hillary remained active politically as First Lady, fighting hard but failing to push through universal health care coverage. In the White House, persistent stories of Bill's infidelities caught up with him with the Monica Lewinsky sex scandal that got him impeached in the U.S. House of Representatives. Months of public humiliation took a toll on Hillary, according to Ron Fournier.
She's changed because of a lot of the stuff that's come her way. She built up a lot of scar tissue because of the attacks that have come her way. Some of them are totally unfair.
The months after the scandal were a painful time. Close Clinton associate Weiner told VOA, but the marriage survived.
They try to deal with their marital failures privately, but they've gotten through them. I've been there and I've seen them, and they love each other.
And Hillary fought her way back, forging her own separate political career. She won election in New York to the U.S. Senate in 2000 and was reelected in 2006. In 2008, Obama appointed her Secretary of State. She visited 112 countries and used the job to highlight women's rights and the power of diplomacy, dubbed soft power. During her speech at the Democratic National Convention this week, First Lady Michelle Obama praised Hillary Clinton's record and character.
There were plenty of moments when Hillary could have decided that this work was too hard, that the price of public service was too high, that she was tired of being picked apart for how she looks or how she talks or even how she laughs. But here's the thing. What I admire most about Hillary is that she never buckles under pressure. She never takes the easy way out. And Hillary Clinton has never quit on anything in her life.
Now Hillary Clinton finds herself in the political fight of her life, running against celebrity businessman Donald Trump. Like Clinton, a world-famous but polarizing figure. Polls show the two are locked in a tight race. Hillary Clinton's life story suggests she will fight as hard as she can all the way to Election Day on November 8th. Cindy Sain, VOA News, The White House.